Hi, this video is going to show you guys how to create the David Hockney collage in the Photoshop full program on your desktop or laptop. I'm also showing you a mobile version for your Chromebook or a phone that is actually going to be in a separate video. This video is just for the desktop version. So starting out, I've already opened Photoshop. Now I suggest starting it this way and then creating a new file. So you're going to go to File, New. This is for your background. You can see I've already created one for the final. I'm going to show you this one in progress to get started. So you can do a 12 by 18, you can do an 8 by 10. It's up to you what you set this to, but make sure it's inches, and then also make sure it's a custom background. And then 300 to 400 resolution is pretty good. I just put in 350. So I'm going to hit create. So here's my background. Now here's my layer. My first layer, it's going to be on the bottom. It's always going to be your background layer. It's already white, so that's okay. Sometimes, depending on what your composition would be, I would suggest doing a black, but I would either choose a black or a white background for your composition. If you wanted to choose a black, you could just come over to your fill bucket. If you don't see a fill bucket and you see this gradient tool, you just right click and then make sure you click the paint fill bucket. Then to get a black, you could just click on the white and then choose any color down here. Or if it's already black down here, you could just hit this little flipper and it'll flip. So if I go, so say, because you can have two colors at once. So if I have two colors, hit the flipper, now the black's on top. So whichever one's on top, that's the color that's going to use whenever you're on your toolbar. So depending if you're with a brush or a fill bucket or whatever it might be. So my fill bucket, I could click it, make it black if I wanted a black background. I'm actually going to control Z back because the background that I use for my composition for this collage for the demonstration is actually white here in the studio. I use the white backdrop, so I am going to choose a white background for this one. So like always, I hit magnifying glass and then fit screen. You can see it better. You're going to end up zooming in and out anyways. To get your first image, I already have my images over here in this folder. So I took the pictures already, I uploaded them to the computer, and now they're over here in the folder. I have it on my desktop, but if you look in here, you can see I took about 40 to 50 images. That's a good amount for you to have to choose from. I didn't end up using all these images in the one final that I made down here, which I'll actually put out and show you in the end what it looked like. So I'll put it up here. Actually, I'll show you right here what it looks like. Take a second to load. So here's what my final looked like. Now, mine is a full figure self-portrait. I'm here in the studio. It seemed to be the best subject, so I just went with that. You could do anything, though. You could do an up-close self-portrait where you're zoomed in. You could do a friend's portrait where you add together, or siblings or family members where you actually add together different parts of the figure or body. You don't even have to do a figure or a body. You could do a landscape. You could do a cityscape. You could do a field. You could do a snowscape, a mountain, a sunset, you know, whatever it is that you decide to do for your composition. But the process is the same, where you're going to take bits and pieces, zoomed in close-up pictures like David Hockney did to create his style of photographic collages, which again he called photo montages. There's different ways to do it. This one's more of a random overlapping and underlapping. Some people do it that way. The other artists that we've viewed that have also done a similar style, photo collaging, because essentially this is just a photo collage. But David Hockney was one of the first people to do this back in the, 20th century. Some of his were more systematically lined up, like you would have like just squares and rows across. But remember, you always have to do, and one of the key things to make this fun and interesting is to take different views, take different perspectives. Don't just take all the pictures from one direction. Move around, go around your subject, look up, look down, look left, look right. So you're creating more of a three-dimensional form, or you can create more of a three-dimensional form with this type of photography and collage. So you can see here, some of them turn left, my hand's up close. My foot is up close. This one's to the left. Actually, I have one. This is actually the side of me. You can see. So it's a mix. So that was the final. But back to creating the beginning, I have my background. I'm ready to go. So I'm going to go to File, Open. I'm going to find my images. I'm just going to start like I did the other one. I'm going to start with the face and go down. So my first image I'll find, there it is, do that one, hit open. Okay, so look what happens. Up here at the top, it comes into a different bar. Every time you open an image across in Photoshop, it puts into a separate file up here in the bar. In order to get this picture into this picture, you're going to go to Select All, Edit, Copy, and then back to the background, Edit, Paste. Now my image is in the background image. You can also see now I have a background with the white background, and then I also have the image, which is the first layer. And every time I create a new layer or put a new image in, it's going to create a new layer. So think of this as a magazine, like an old school magazine collage, where you have a background, you're cutting out pieces of a magazine, you're collaging them on top. Whatever layer is on top is what's going to be on top in here. So to move pictures around, obviously I want to make this smaller if I'm going to do a full figure portrait. So you have to think in advance, what size and scale do I want to start with so I don't run out of room? So your favorite, your best friend here is Edit, Free Transform. And now you can shrink it or enlarge it, whatever you like to do. But I'd say maybe something around there to start. And then to set it, you can either just click the arrow or double click the picture, and that sets it. You could always come back later and move it around again. But you want to be careful you don't run out of room. Because if I start too big, and by the time I get down here to the bottom, I'm going to run out of space. I might, get cut off at the knees or the feet, but I know when I get everything in there. There are ways to actually merge the layers together by selecting them, right-click, and then merging the layers, and then shrinking all of them down at once if you find yourself in that predicament. But for beginning, just make sure you feel like you're giving yourself enough room. So let me just do the same process again. So we File, Open, find my next picture, go with this one. Just going to start with the head, work my way down. So it came in larger. Back to your Edit, Free Trans, or sorry, first we have to select. Another thing I always do is once I have the image and in the other background, I get rid of it. So I don't accidentally delete this background with my images. Another good thing to do is just go ahead and save it. So I'm going to go to File, Save As, and just save it as the Photoshop file. Okay, do that so you know as you work, and periodically save it. Make sure like every 3 to 5 images you're saving it. Because you don't want to actually accidentally delete it, or if your computer program crashes or something, you don't want to lose your work. So remember, this is a working Photoshop file. So now I'm to my next image. I'm going to go to Select All, Edit, Copy, get rid of the image, and then now I'm in my background, Edit, Paste. So once again, see here, I got my background, layer 1, layer 2. Whatever layer you're in is what layer you're editing here. So sometimes people get confused and they say, I'm trying to move this picture and it won't let me move this picture. You might be in the wrong layer. So always make sure you're in the right layer. Whichever one's highlighted, that's the one you're editing. So I'm going to go back to this one, Edit, Free Transform, shrink it down, and then zoom in. Now, one thing you want to pay attention to, double click and set it for a second. When you're zoomed out like this, when you move it around, it makes bigger jumps as it moves. So one thing to do a more detailed move, a more precise move to line things up, is if you go to your magnifying glass, zoom in, and now when I go to my move tool, this is a move tool, or my edit free transform, when I move it, I'm moving smaller increments of space, okay? So something to keep in mind. I could leave a space. I could, David Hockney leaves a space in a lot of his. I could butt the pictures right up next to each other. That's up to you. Remember, this is your piece, your composition. I'm just showing you how to get started and kind of line things up. So there's my third picture. Double click and set it. I'm going to zoom back out. Do my third one. So same process. You just keep repeating now. So you go to File, Open. Maybe I'll start grabbing some of the body and working down. So click this, my neck, body, shoulder. Another thing you could do if you don't want the whole picture is you could go to your square marquee tool and only select a little bit less. Like maybe you only want like that much. You could just select that, edit, copy that, and then when you go to your background and edit, paste, it's only going to paste in the part that you selected. So that is an option. I'm going to Control Z back because I actually do want the whole picture. I'm just going to go to select all. You also have other selection tools here, remember. So you have your quick selection tool. If you just want to select a part of a picture and paste it into the other image, you have your lasso tool. I would suggest the quick selection tool is the best. There's also other YouTube videos on the quick selection tool if you want to refer to that if you forget how to use the quick selection on the channel. So select all, edit copy, close the image, edit, paste, edit, free transform, shrink it down, put it in there, maybe go a little larger, maybe something like that. Now, I don't like this picture on top. I actually want this background picture on top, so I'm going to show you what happens here. So right here, I'm going to go zoom back in so I can see it a little bit better. Move my bar over here if I want to arrange it. All you have to do to make this picture on top of this picture is drag this picture, because this is the one we just put in, underneath the other picture. So if I put this down here, see now this one's underneath. So now that one's where I want. I kind of like that look better, so maybe move that over. Remember, this is a collage. It's more on the abstract side. You can make things, you don't have to keep it all in proportion. You could make things big or small. That's up to you. So I could even take this and go out of proportion if I wanted to make some parts bigger, you know. This is where the creating part comes in for you. So I'm going to stop there because this is just to help you guys get started. But remember, layers, start with the background. And just keep working. You're going to do, I would try at least 20 to 30 pictures. I think I ended up with around 20, 25 in the final that I tried. You can also play around with transparency. Let me show you that really quick before we get off. Maybe I want a little bit of the other picture to show through. You got to make sure what layer you're in. So if I go here and click on, make sure I'm in that layer. If I go to my opacity and just scroll this down, see now I can start to see through the layers, which is kind of a fun thing. That's up to you too, if you want to try something like that. To play around with the opacity and the transparency of the picture. So that picture that I'm in, it's actually now 62% transparency. That's why you can start to see through it a little bit. So anyways, if you have any questions, email me, let me know. Have fun. Thanks for watching. Talk to you soon.